Did you push play? Are we starting now?
What are you saying to me? God, it's gorgeous outside.
It's a beautiful day, isn't it?
Oh my God, this is the prettiest day.
Let's go for a ride.
Like ever.
Honey.
Honey, take me for a spin. Look at Ace over there. There's a dog on a leash.
Everybody, welcome to Incredible Tiny Homes on this beautiful Tuesday.
Oh my, Randy, look at the sky.
Wow.
Now that is gorgeous.
Man, do we not have everything in the world to be thankful for?
Oh my God, blue, green, white,
howdy.
Gorgeous.
We are fixing, as they say here in Tennessee.
It's a fixing.
We're a fixing.
We're a fixing too.
Oh no, here's Will. Here's our miracle man.
Hey,
Will.
Hey, Will. Doing good.
Say hi to your beautiful wife, because you'll be watching her tonight when you're in the bed. You know who I'm talking about. Hey, Will, it'll be funny now because you'll be watching you and me while you're in bed with your wife.
What? Why you always got to make it sound so icky?
Well, he's the one that started it.
Has anything changed? How is that new?
That's right. That's true. Same thing. Yep. You'll be on the screen, too.
Yeah, I've been on a couple.
Yeah, you'll be on them. How's it going, buddy?
It's going good. This week was a little bit of a challenge today getting started. We had to do a little bit of plumbing, rearrange.
Oh, yeah,
the plumbing.
That faucet and stuff. Okay.
Yeah, and then cut down and rearrange the drain. We got that. I got all the drywall up. It's ready to go, ready for the Schluter system tomorrow.
Nice.
And this is Gloria's house.
Gloria's house, yep. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yep. She had it painted, and isn't that a pretty house?
It is. It's a big shower, too. I think it's one of the biggest ones we've done.
It is.
Beautiful.
6 feet by 6 feet.
Yep.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to be nice.
Yes.
Wow. Nice. Everybody knows Will. Will does all our tile work.
Yep.
And he had a massive injury. I was sick for you, man.
We were very sad.
I was just so sad.
Yeah.
I know you were, of course, way worse than that, but his hand looks perfect. He tore it up.
Miracle.
With a grinder
amazing.
That had a chainsaw grinding blade on it. It got away from him, and it looked like he was going to be gone.
It was January 23rd.
And
oh, my goodness.
He has come back without even hardly a scar.
Yeah, and now I can, when I got it out of the splint a month after surgery, that's all I could do.
Oh, my goodness.
So
that scare you,
every
man.
Day, a little bit. Physical
that
therapy.
That is scary.
Yeah.
Physical therapy. I can't
yes.
say enough about those guys.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And now I can almost, it's almost the same.
Wow.
Yeah. I'm
bless your heart.
I'm very grateful.
Very, yeah. Yes.
I know what it's like. If you can't work, oh, like I said, it messes with your head.
It does.
Everything, you know, you're off your routine.
And anyone watching this that knows that they've been through it, I mean, oh, mm-hmm. my heart just, oh. It's
yeah.
Just, it's
yes.
horrible to go through it.
Tough on you.
And yeah. And
well, because, it's a trauma.
Yeah, and like mm-hmm. I was telling you guys, I mean, the biggest hurdle is getting over it inside your head.
Yes.
I'm so stupid. I'm so worthless now. I can't do what I did.
Yes.
All these negative things, and you got to just.
Turn that off,
yeah.
man.
You got to turn it off, or you got to get help to turn it off.
Yeah, that's right.
So.
Yep.
But that's why I like working here. So.
Because we're all doing stupid stuff.
Yeah, no. That's what we're all doing. Here, it's all this great energy.
That's
man.
Right.
Hey, come here. I'll show you how many things I've done wrong. God Almighty.
All your fingers and toes.
That's right.
Oh.
Yeah.
We are so tickled that I mean that because when they told me. I just, my mouth, I was like, oh my God. And
they showed you the picture.
Oh,
they showed me the picture,
sick, man.
Yeah.
I know what that's like. It's like, oh.
Yeah, I don't want to put it on. I could pull it up on my phone, but
no.
I don't.
Oh, it is, it's bad.
It is bad, so.
Well.
That's why it's a miracle, the way it looks.
Well, I had some great surgeons and great, you know, physical therapists, and I'm just so grateful.
Wow.
We are too. Yeah.
So the only thing with Bill, now because of his injury, he thinks he can get here at 10 o'clock and leave at 4.
Why do you do people like this? Yeah.
Banker's hours.
Oh,
I was not. I was going to wash your mouth out with soap when you said that. Came up. I got up at 6:30 this morning.
Oh, so your wife didn't know you didn't get here until 10, huh? Oh,
you know,
we got to go.
Loading the truck.
Okay. Hey, he
didn't. Hey, Tim,
sweetheart, he didn't get here until about 10:30, okay?
You can't explain nothing to him. Will, don't even.
We got to go. See you later.
See you, Will. That's in Gloria's house. You're a mess. You know that you are a blank stir.
I didn't know. I didn't
you're a blank
know.
Stir. You know what blank is?
Blank. Is that blank for a cuss word, Amanda?
Blank for a cuss word. Yes, it is.
Look.
100%.
Ace is going to attack that dog.
Hey, how are you?
Aww. All right, here's a, we call it the Boneyard, and this is amazing, way better than it used to be. These are all metal roofings that are going on our homes. We're sectioning them out. It is so, you got 20, 30 homes.
Things are getting so much better.
Where to put all this stuff is just a challenge for sure.
We want to love that blue house.
We want to show you some stucco, all right? We want to show you the technique, how it's looking, what we're doing. Ah, right here.
Okay.
All right, let's go look at a few.
That still does not look like the same house on here, but now
it doesn't look teal.
It does not look teal
on the screen.
No,
it looks blue.
It looks more teal than it ever has, but it's still blue on my screen.
It looks blue.
That looks better. This is my new phone. It looks more like it.
It looks more like the real thing.
I like that. I like that light blue.
I love that light blue with that copper. That looks really nice.
Which one would you like to show off the most, Pandy?
I like that one, and I like
The inside of this one? Is it a white?
Yeah, Tice's is done.
Okay.
It's almost clean. You could go in there.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Let's do that.
White's,
okay,
so cool.
They're going to have it done tomorrow, so,
yeah. And this is the new technique we're using to put to cover up the screws. So we're using a product to cover all the screws first, and then we're going to stucco, and it's we're thinking this is the deal right here.
What's the process, or did you want to explain that? Or?
Well, we're just covering this up, right? All the screws with a different product, and then we're coming over top of it with the stucco
What's
flex.
What's the product you're putting on
It's
there?
A secret potion that
I've
invented.
Oh, I was going to say, are you got a tail?
No, I'm not saying
Don't
everything.
Tell, I was going to say.
No.
Oh, we don't want to
It's the same
it.
Thing that I'm not going to tell everybody everything. I'll show a little bit of something.
Oh, exactly. That's right.
That's
we
right.
Probably want to introduce Pandy because it's a date. Well, go ahead.
Yep.
You get the mic.
This is Pandy.
Hi.
Pandy from Idaho, California, whatever, but you come from Idaho.
Yes.
Her husband's building houses inside here. Mm-hmm. And then she
David.
Has, David, she came here wanting to work, wanting to do something, and she has actually spearheaded the stucco crew.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
So she's overseeing them, keeping them organized, the houses, what to do, what products to use, what quality to use, clean, going, keeping them humping.
We're doing it.
Yeah. And working
and
with Dennis.
Happening.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, we're going to get them done. Yep.
I couldn't believe how, man, she puts the hours in, works right along with the guys. I mean, it's end of the day and still going.
Mm-hmm.
And but it's coming along
it
a lot.
Is. It's
really
together.
Good. So.
We're excited.
Yeah.
Yes.
Thank you.
Yay.
You're going to get your house soon.
Exactly. There you go.
Good. All right. Thank you,
Pandy.
You're welcome.
Yep. So this is Mike's house. Now, he doesn't want to stucco the outside. He doesn't want us. So the homeowner will stucco this.
Oh, he's going to do the outside?
Yeah. Okay. And when he gets here, we'll give him some pointers of what, you know, kind of what
sure,
to do.
What works, what doesn't.
So come here. Come here, Mandy.
I'm coming. Was that music?
Oh yeah, let me see if I can. Hey you.
Hey, don't you scare me.
Can we come in? We're gonna come in there and film this. Is that all right? You stay right where you are. We won't show you. I gotta turn that radio down. Can I turn it down?
Yeah, it's the phone.
Oh, it's the phone? Let me see how I can do that. They're gonna. Oh, I just paused it.
Anyway, look at it.
This, no, we're just going to show how good it looks in here. Hey, Amanda, come here.
All right, well, get rid of the bucket so they can see.
Oh, they're all right.
Yeah, I'm not
coming up there. Okay, I'll show it.
Yeah,
all right, everybody. Hey, I'm going to show you just the finish on the inside of this thing and how smooth. Look at that wall. All right, let me try to, I'm going to try it this way. All right. Look, I'm going to back up a little bit. Look at that ceiling. Everybody, we are getting this stuff. It is looking,
that
look
is
at that.
Nice.
Yeah, this looks really good. Yep. There's Julie.
Smart.
Jules, Juliana.
Gotta
be smart. She's overseeing the finishing touches of this.
Gotta be smarter than a fifth grader. Okay, did it work?
You're doing
oh,
great.
There you go.
Look at this, everybody. I'm talking nice. This is the baseboard. We're starting to use a wood baseboard to accent it. I'm gonna just let it speak for itself. I mean, look at this. Isn't this nice? I really like how it's turning out. Yeah, and then back. Oh, look, Amanda. This is an 8 by 24, so from here,
8 with 24 at the loft, and I'm going to walk back this way. Give you guys, this is an RJO floor plan with a washer and dryer, of course, bathroom here, kitchen, of course, range hood, and I'm going to turn around from the front door and go back. Is this not awesome with the egress windows, sprinkler system, ceiling fan will be going up when they're done. All right, Amanda.
It'll be interesting, the homeowner actually doing it, to see what kind of difficulties, or if he knows how to do it, or whatever happens.
See how he comes along with that.
Yeah, how he comes along, so.
Cool.
Yeah, that definitely doesn't look like teal right there. So it is not that color.
That is a nice color.
Look, come here, look at the difference.
It's blue.
It's blue.
It looks blue in your phone.
That's not it.
And it's a teal, man, for sure.
Yeah, exactly. That is not it.
We got an army out here doing these things, Amanda. It's taking longer than we thought, but man, we want to do them right. And it's just the process that we're putting it down, you know?
Yeah.
We've got three more up in the Amish country.
Yeah.
And they're starting to build more up that way, so.
And they're 10 by 20s,
once
right?
These get cranking, we're gonna be having 5, 6, 7 at a time being built.
And the majority of the people did get stucco.
Yeah, did they? Yeah, we've
got. I'm asking, yeah.
Oh yeah, we got a truckload today that come in.
Yeah. That house looks great, that blue one.
Yeah, and that's just the first coat. They got to do another coat on the outside.
I love that. That looks good.
Yeah, but we're learning how to, like this product here, we're playing with this to patch coat all the screws and everything, and then going over top of it. I called the manufacturer, talked to them about what we're doing. I've talked to some guys out in the field.
Look at all the stucco. That's only some of it. That's only some.
$85 a bucket. All right, let's go.
Where are we going?
Out to the beach, in the prairie, and across the street.
Okay. I want my phone to get
on. All right, come on. We'll show you guys what's going on with our communities. We'd like to do a weekly update. We didn't do it last week, so I want to show you kind of what's going on.
All I got to do was that video, kind of showing. Hey, Jason.
Well,
news about the beach.
Yeah, we have had the first electricity ran to a meter today.
Wow.
Now the homeowner, all they have to do is they have to activate their meter.
Wow.
And that'll be it. So here's the beach. We started at the very end down here.
Okay.
We had a lady move on to her lot sooner, you know, before we were ready, and we've got her on a generator. We've been keeping it full of gas. It's been about a week now, 24/7 on a generator, and I'm ready for her to get plugged in.
We probably need to take this off.
Oh yeah, let me do that.
Yeah.
Oh, how's that?
There you go. Yeah.
Okay. So the meters, let me show you this right here. They got a blue sticker on them.
That means it's passed?
That means it's passed. They got a meter and it's good. So all the homeowner has to do is call in and activate it.
Okay.
All right.
So how many are passed?
Three. This one, and the next one.
One, two, and three.
Yep. That one there.
Yeah,
that one, they'll come by tonight, check on it again. Yep. And get that. So we've got the first three lots, it'll be the first four lots. Hopefully tomorrow they'll check on it.
And this is previously Bryce's container. The customer now, Joy, has it.
Mm-hmm.
Beautiful, she bought it.
Yeah. Okay. Oh look, we got a street sign up.
Yeah.
Well, I'll be darned. Isn't that cool?
That is cool.
This is Malibu.
Mm-hmm.
And I know it. We just got, this is just the beginning of everything and how this is all going to start looking. Wow, look at that, Malibu Way.
Yeah, beautiful.
So, we've been waiting for parts. I mean, for 3 weeks, parts. And then it was another part the state required. They needed something else required. We got it all in. We talked to the inspector. We're all set. Now we just need to put it together.
Look at this tiny, I ordered these. Well, Kelly, I asked Kelly to order the signs. The stop sign, can we go up there and see the stop sign, how tiny it is?
Yeah.
We got a tiny stop sign. And that's as big as we could get, that we could find. But it's so fitting for the tiny town way. Look at this tiny little stop sign. My goodness. Yeah. And it's on Tiny Town Way.
We were informed it's on the wrong side of the road.
I know, because it probably does need to be on the other side.
Well, we need it because we got the shed there, and people are going to miss it, you know?
Because I don't think it didn't say Tiny Town on the other side, does it?
Oh, that.
That's what I think she mainly
the stop sign. Ace, you stay, buddy.
That's cute. Those are so tiny. Come here, Ace.
Yeah, it says
it. Oh, it does, so it's fine.
It's That'd just the fine. Stop sign normally is on the right.
Yeah, normally on the right, but the shed's there, so that works out. Oh, my God, it just feels amazing today.
Yeah, you got a cool breeze.
Oh, my God, this breeze.
Look at the clouds. It's like they're sitting up in the sky.
What else did you want to say about the beach? So we sent out a letter this morning. Do we want to talk about that or no?
Well, apparently, I guess we do. You mentioned it, man.
Well,
so go
I mean,
right
it's
ahead.
Up to you. You don't
go
have
right
to
ahead.
Say anything.
Oh, I'm not in charge of this train.
You can sit there and just bite your lip.
Go right ahead. What about it? What does your little email say?
Well, what my little email said is that for one of the things, because not all of the lots will be completed, right? Though not all will not all have power all at the same time.
Yes, it's a three or four step process.
I asked Randy, would it be okay if we go ahead and if their houses are ready and we schedule it and get their houses placed on their lot, okay? Can they bring a generator like Joy is doing at their own expense? And if they needed to go ahead and move their things in, or if they needed to go ahead and move in, can they do that?
Mm-hmm.
And you said that would be fine. So I asked Kelly to send out an email to all the people on the beach to give them that option until the power is turned on to their lot.
So in other words, all that said, if you want to move here, you can just use a generator.
Exactly. But and I added more things in there too. It's like, you know, one of the things is that, you know, we can't assist with the generator. You just got to take care of yourself on that kind of stuff, you know. There's certain places we kind of want to talk about tonight. There's certain places now you just can't walk and be around. And we want to let everybody know that too, because people are innocently walking around and not knowing that they're not supposed to be in certain areas. Because it is a construction area.
This is the
area.
Deal. All right. Well, this is the thing. You know, we're changing. We're transforming into a corporation. And as much as I hate it, you know, I like to just live and go with it. And you want everybody to get along and everybody be okay. And if something happens, everybody gives a handshake. They know, hey, it was my fault, whatever it was. And it's just not that way anymore.
The world's not like that.
We can't. I have learned it firsthand right here. Now we have to run by the rules. I hate it. It's like big corporation or it's real world stuff. You know, man, we had workshops here. We had people just signing a waiver and chop saws, using table saws, nail guns. And I had a guy that was insurance company. He said he was just like,
you probably passed out.
Oh my God, you're doing this?
Yeah.
And I don't even think we could probably even do it now.
No.
You know, and I hate that. But
I'm glad we got to do it. Nobody got hurt.
Yeah, we were told we need a barrier around everything and a part of the corporation, the manufacturing end of it. And I will do it. It's just a matter of money and time, manpower to do it. But in the meantime, you know, we have people living on the corporation property that needs to move off of there.
And they're almost
and
all gone.
We were actually asking some of the beach people that are not going to move to their beach house, the beach lot for a while, if we could use their lot, I'll activate the electricity so I could put those folks over here until the prairie is done, you know, and we'll work together or something like that. I bootlegged some power over there the other day from a lot. I just thought, hey, I'll just plug it up with an extension cord from somebody. But you can't do that. You got to ask. You got to send emails and you got to sign stuff. And I'm like, I hate being in the real world.
I know.
You know?
Yeah, but rules. And too, with so many people coming here, it's just for safety, insurance, we have to. So one of the things we want to talk about.
But it doesn't stop. It's like, okay, well, they're going to say, well, you know what? Your stop sign wasn't big enough, so I hit somebody. Now I'm going to sue you because my stop sign wasn't big enough.
Well, I mean, it's a risk you take. It's just so you do the best you can. But the one thing we do know is that I just wanted to kind of, you tell everybody where the separation is and what they're saying about where people can be and where they can't be.
Yeah. All right. So we put a gate down here. So when you come into Tiny Town, there's no reason why anybody should be pointing this direction right here.
Yeah.
All right. Let me back up a little bit and I'll show you. When you come into Tiny Town, right now until when the prairie's added, as soon as you pull in here, this is the gate.
Yes.
Oh, Ace following us.
You're a visitor.
But this is the gate. You don't need to be going straight. Either you go to the right. That's where all the communities are.
Yes, right.
All right. I was going to put a gate up here, but you have the prairie will be the entrance down here, mm-hmm. where that white truck is. So
right.
we got a gate just beyond that. So mm-hmm. right now, nobody goes beyond where those guys are standing in the white truck.
Well, and two, until it's not a construction zone, you can't go on the prairie. So nobody can
right.
go on the prairie. They can only go on the forest or the beach.
Until everything's done on
until
the prairie.
Until everything's done.
Really, I mean, it's not done on
they
the
really
beach
either.
They
really can't go on the beach yet. So until
but the
it's
thing
done.
Is, Amanda, we started this business with people with... I gave that mindset to everybody. We all like it to be able to be laissez-faire. And
that's
you know,
fun, yeah.
And, you know, they love... I hate that people can't come in here and watch the guys work and see the homes. It's just
yeah.
such a beautiful thing
mm-hmm.
to see these things being built, you
yeah.
know? But... Anyway,
yeah. we just
you
have
know
to
what?
Change.
I'm
that's
still
it.
Confused by it. But
we just have to change. That's all.
Yeah. You know what? It would be easier if it was done. If the fences were up, everything was cleaned up, and
yeah.
everything was completed, it would be a lot easier to, you know, kind of get everybody on.
Well,
the,
of course it would.
You know?
Yeah.
So. You know what? When we started this prairie, I thought, well, all we have to do is cut in the driveways, cut in the house sites, right?
Yeah.
And cut in the roads. But then when you dig a ditch for all the electricity,
yeah.
that's 5 feet deep. Then you dig the sewer that's a little bit deeper than that. And then you go back and you dig your water lines. Then you dig your communication lines. Amanda.
How much have we overspent?
This whole 7-8 acres, every bit of it. Every bit of this has been covered by a machine 3, 4, 5 times. So that's why there's no grass left.
Can I guess how much?
And then what we're going to do now is this road right through here
mm-hmm.
and every house site and every parking spot on each lot is going to have to go down about 6 inches. So
again?
all the dirt's got to come out of here. So what we had to do is make this all a beautiful grade. So when it pours the rain, all the water runs off of this property.
Oh my God.
That's what was so hard in the forest, because you cannot grade all the forest, right? So we still got areas in the forest that hold water when it rains.
Right.
And we're trying to funnel that out and add fill and a little bit of a, you know, we just got 2 or 3 places like that.
Yeah.
But here, now we'll take out all the dirt for the parking, the roads, and the house parking. We'll come out. Then we'll put fabric down, which is 6,600 lineal feet of fabric and gravel 6 inches thick throughout this whole thing.
Man.
Then we go over here and we put the meter centers up, cut
yeah.
our pipe, put the mm-hmm. meter centers over top of them, cut our sewer, get the boxes in, all that. And then we can pull our wire, secondary wire, which we're gonna start pulling it now. Then the transformers come and hook it and them up. So. At least Yump's work will be gone. We'll be going across the street.
Yeah.
And then it's just putting all the mechanicals in place.
At the mountain.
Yeah.
So it is coming along.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. It's going to be a couple months for this. But I don't have a doubt that it won't be ready for the
Look
jam.
Nice. Yeah.
For the jam coming. So I think we'll be fine there. The reason is because we've already ordered the meter centers, you know. Look at him running.
He loves chasing them birds. Come on, Ace. Look at him. Look at him.
Running after those birds.
Look at him. You know they just toy with him. There's his water.
Yep, there's our Caribbean pond.
It's green.
You can see the bottom, beautiful.
I know.
Isn't that nice?
Look at that. God, Ace loves the ponds.
And there is
Look
the prairie.
Look how gorgeous everything is.
Oh, sorry about
Look
that.
Look at the sky. Look at the clouds and everything, Randy. It's beautiful.
Hey, I gotta get this real quick. She's at the at Lowe's.
Okay.
Let me get it real quick. Hey. All right, we'll wait. We'll wait on that. I don't need it right now. We'll wait and see if we can't find another alternative. Hey, won't you get some of them? We'll give it a shot. I don't know. Get probably a dozen of them. Yeah. All right. Thank you, Jan. Bye. Sorry, everybody. Got things going on all the time.
Business.
Yeah. Yep. So that's the prairie. And you know, somebody asked me, they said, how come you've left all this land and didn't put homes on it?
Mm-hmm.
I'm like, because I just wanted this to look real pretty one day with a big pond and an island. And
you don't want it to be too crowded.
Yeah, and you can sit here. There's so many things that are going to be built here.
And everybody's got to have their dogs, and you got to have a place to like walk around and relax.
$200 a month.
Come on. It's not always going to look like this, guys.
No.
It's really not.
It's under construction.
It's under construction.
You know, and I know I've always had this thing where, not that I'm a late bloomer, but I have been in a way that I get these things rolling, and it has to look ugly before it looks good. And and I'm always before my time,
mm-hmm.
and people get so uptight,
mm-hmm.
because they're so anxious, they don't have the patience to see, mm-hmm. what I've started here,
yeah.
and that's why I give the deals that I do,
mm-hmm.
$200 a month, you know, for whatever time, and they get it for 3 months, three mm-hmm. years,
yeah.
you know, and the deal that they're getting for their homes and all that, and you guys wait. You guys wait till this is all done. It's kind of exhausting when you have to constantly explain yourself, you know, and what you're doing. But
I think everybody can really see the vision now, especially with the forest.
I hope so.
The way it looks and stuff.
Yeah.
Was we going across the mountain?
Do you want to do that?
My phone's still good right now. How are we going to get over without getting killed?
And we got Ace.
Yeah, I don't think we can't take Ace over. He's got to be put up. Now, we could drive through the forest if you wanted to.
You want to do that?
Yeah, let's do that.
We'll do that one maybe Friday. We'll do our show over
Let's do our show over at the mountain Friday, because I'm afraid to not drive the other vehicle.
And follow me.
Yeah, I like following Randy over. I don't like I don't want to get smashed in the golf cart.
Somebody text us and they'd be texting and then run into us.
Oh my gosh. Hey, can we go? You can't go backwards. We can't go around the other way.
Oh, that's a great idea.
Let's go backwards. Yeah, let's go in reverse. We've never done that.
Reverse.
Would we start up there? We wouldn't. We'd start right here.
What do you want to do?
Well, whatever you think we ought to do. I think we ought to start from the beginning. Or from the end. So.
Let's start 3/4 of the way.
Okay, let's do that. To kind of explain. This is the Milligan Mile. And for those who don't know why it's called Milligan Mile, that's Randy's mom's maiden name, mm-hmm. Milligan.
Yep.
And she always liked to extricize, she would say. And she still does. She's still alive, so.
Yep. Yeah, mom's 95, and she still does her, she calls it extricize.
Extricize.
And she still does that. And I want to tell you, the water is live on here now.
Oh my God, I see it.
They turned the water on.
Oh, so wow.
No leaks. Everything's working great.
Oh, that's fantastic. So
this is the Milligan Mile, named after Mom.
This is the end
She's
of it.
She's 95. So you get to go back through here. We're going to plant another hedge through here to cover this
Woo.
Up. There wasn't enough tree cover to do the complete tunnel.
So here
tunnel.
We go.
So if you walk this, we can walk all the way around this 34 acres.
So you just got out of your house at the prairie.
Yep.
And you want to walk to the forest.
Here we go.
Here we go.
Yep. Duck your head.
Woo!
Yep. We'll be cleaning this up and giving it a nice trail.
Oh, here comes Ace.
Man, today is a perfect temperature.
This is summertime. This is what I remember as a kid. I don't remember it being sweltering hot as a kid.
Really?
That's what I'd miss about, like, summer used to be fantastic like this. I don't remember hot days.
It's like
days.
80 degrees, low
yes.
humidity. And
I used to lay in the grass and be in the woods, and I never was hot. But you're a kid, too, so you ain't paying attention to much. So maybe I just don't remember it.
I remember one time we needed air conditioning as a kid.
We never had air conditioning.
So this pond will be bigger, three times bigger than what it is.
Oh, look, you can see the clouds in it. It's going to be our little Lake Tahoe, ain't it?
That's it. Yeah.
Little Lake Tahoe. Tiny Tahoe.
Tiny Tahoe.
Tiny Tahoe.
I would like to have little cottages stuck back in these
sure,
trees.
Sure, of course.
Who knows what we're going to do?
Who knows? It's just fun. Tiny Tahoe. That goes along with the Western stuff.
TNT. Don't
it? Well, I was going to say we couldn't do those, but who knows?
So this was the spur.
Yeah.
We took up the rails on the spur.
Oh, did we? Yeah, it's gone.
That's all the railroad tracks.
Oh, the railroad ties.
Ties.
Now, listen, when I was growing up, every flower bed anywhere around had railroad ties because people would go down to the railroad, steal them, and take them, carry them up to the house and put
yeah.
them around and make a flower bed.
You can't steal them now.
Oh, you can't now.
There's
no.
our tracks.
There's the tracks.
Yep.
That is cool. We're still on the Milligan Mile. There's the boneyard.
All this,
the bone yard.
It's all going to be gone first of the year.
Yep.
Everything will
Beautiful.
Be gone. Yep.
Look how pretty. Beautiful.
Yes.
Look how nice and clean everything is. There's where the houses are. Oh, look here.
Isn't that pretty?
That's leaving soon.
Yep. California.
Mm-hmm. California A.
This is kind of like our closet back here.
It really is.
But we're cleaning this up too, getting yep. as we get organized.
Here's the back of the wood shop.
Yep.
That's where they kind of take a break back there and meet up, guys.
Yep.
We're going to feature Bryce's house sometime, too.
Yeah, Mark's
got a great guy that he's here renting that. It looks fantastic.
Want to do a couple little more things to make it look really
yeah.
nice, and then we'll show Bryce's
we'll
house.
We'll show it, yeah.
I pulled that to Oregon and back. The Milligan Mile will eventually go straight, Amanda.
It will eventually go through
yep.
there.
Go right through here, over a little bridge. Yep, and go through the woods and around. Yep.
But right now, and this is what we call the lake lots right
yep.
now.
These are temporary living.
Temporary living,
until
yeah.
people are into the prairie or beach,
yep.
and we are maxed out here.
And people are making very good use of their tiny space. You know, their temporary space.
Yeah.
I mean.
This is like a RV park.
Yeah.
In here.
So this is not going to stay like this.
Nope.
You even consider blocking this road off.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. And then over here are lake lots.
Yeah, they're a part of those. You go down here at the very end, right?
Yep. You got the hillbilly house mm-hmm. over there.
We haven't got to see the hillbilly house set up.
So this is kind of a little jog you do to get back into the park. Mm-hmm. So you get a beautiful park here you'll be walking through. But when we're done, you'll be walking along the tracks back here, and you'll enter in over here. You won't come in, enter in this way.
Curtis, one of the lots, if they come back tonight, you said they're going to inspect it tonight? Is that what you said?
For electricity?
Yeah.
Mm-mm.
Oh, nope. I thought that's what you said. Anyway, his is the first one. So when they approve that, he gets to move his house. That's Curtis's lot.
Okay, good.
Yeah. I just want to look. There's the house. You can't even see the houses through there.
Oh, look at that.
It's
so pretty?
Private. Look. You can't even see the houses through there.
This trail.
I love this.
This is the hiking trail, Milligan Mile.
And I just want to show, this is the little park. Beautiful. Look at that. Oh my gosh, look how pretty it is. Milligan Mile, we're still on it. This is, you know, I mentioned to somebody and they love the idea. All this to the right of us is the park. And I think, and Randy probably agrees, we all need to get together and just have a great big weekend and clean it, pick up branches, and get it ready probably around the fall time maybe or something. Well, you didn't agree to that. Are you not wanting to help clean it up?
What weekend will that be?
Oh, I'm busy that weekend. I'm gone. Oh my God, the temperature just changed.
Mm.
Oh my goodness.
This was left as a park. Isn't that just, I love it, man.
I love it. This is so, you get to enjoy this, everybody. This is not just for the forest people.
Mm-mm.
This is for everybody.
You can walk around this whole thing if you live in a prairie.
Gorgeous.
Yep.
You can put up some hammocks.
This will transform
too. Some benches.
Yep.
You know, go out here and read a book, walk around. Beautiful. You cannot see the houses. This is so pretty. There's the railroad.
Yep.
Going up around. We're gonna, very first thing's gonna be what, Tamarack?
Yes.
Tamarack will be at the right. It'll be Will and Becky's house. One of their houses. Right up here to the right. See, remember Will and Becky's house right there? Beautiful. And let's look down through Tamarack here. Isn't it gorgeous? Look at there.
Wow.
And there's a couple of people out talking. I think one of them's Curtis.
Yep. And the Milligan Mile will...
continues on.
Yeah. Let's see if we can go up that hill, Amanda.
Oh, God. I hope so. Oh, God, Randy, look at this. Yeah, it'll make it, won't it?
Piece of cake, man.
Oh, gosh, I hope so. Oops. There's Upper Tamarack.
This is still part of the Milligan Mile. You walk.
Yeah.
You don't have to walk down the streets.
No.
If you zigzag the streets and did this, you'd mm-hmm. be well over a mile.
Oh, wow. Yeah, well over. Here's the Jack Pine.
Look at him.
Ace!
Oh, my.
Oh, God. Oh, my word.
And then you go, you walk down this street as part of Milligan
Mile. Walk down this street, yeah.
Yeah. Let me back up here. We have to put these little gates up because there are people that come here that are not, that don't live here.
Right.
And they actually don't know, they don't know that this is not a road,
right,
even though
exactly.
the gravel stops. We had a lady mm-hmm. that pulled in on the Milligan Mile and got stuck.
And got stuck.
We're gonna go through here.
Oh my God, it is so nice and cool.
People working on their house.
Yeah, working on their houses. Oh, that's a nice color. That's like the the purple on the
stucco house.
The Mad Hatter.
Oh yeah, I forgot about the Mad Hatter.
Yeah.
I love that container.
That container looks great.
That is one classy looking container.
Mm-hmm. That looks very sleek.
And he polyed his house over here.
Yes, Joseph.
Yep, love that thing.
Beautiful. And that's a big craftsman.
Yep. So this is part of the Milligan Mile.
Gorgeous. She's got the prettiest.
Look at her beans. Look at her beans.
Garden. My goodness.
Look at it, Noah's.
Noah's house is
Noah's
adorable.
Is just.
Look at that. Look at the one back there. It's so
sweet,
cute.
Man.
Rebecca's. My goodness.
David's.
It's a bee. There is David's house. Hmm. Oh my gosh.
That's cool seeing people. Look at his barbecue he's got. Look at that.
That is fantastic. They have got, look at their yard. They have got it dolled up. And they're doing a house. Oh, that is super cute.
That's Donna's old house.
Mm-hmm. Jesse's back here.
Another container.
Yep, that is Chuck's house.
That looks good in the woods, doesn't it?
Yeah, it sure does. Still have some empty lots around.
So this is part of the Milligan Mile right here.
Yeah.
So you'll come out to Tiny Town.
Mm-hmm.
You turn left, and it'll take you back out to the beach and the prairie.
Yeah, exactly. It's neat because people have got all kinds of plants, their ladders, their tools, everything out because they've been working on them. So there's Will and Becky's place. Look at the corner lot they got. Hey guys, they're on the deck. They got a beautiful deck, got a beautiful setup. We can't express enough how these lots, people really did not want them. I don't think they could understand what these were gonna look like. Look at their deck there. Isn't that gorgeous?
Yep.
We did fantastic with it.
Yep. You know, and I know I've said this before, but this is an industrial area, not industrial park, all right? And when I started this, the city and the county, they thought we'd lost our minds.
Yes.
They thought there was no way anybody
people wanted to come.
Would ever live here. They didn't think it could ever even look nice.
Right.
And we are sold out to capacity, and people are still wanting to move here. We still have a waiting list, I guess. I don't really take in a waiting list anymore.
Yeah.
So we're trying to figure out how we can get some more houses in here.
I mean, people are begging us. They said, are you going to have any more places?
Yep.
Look at the gravel. I can't even tell you how much money that is sitting there. Like, oh my gosh.
I know it.
Every time me and Alyssa see the gravel truck. Something else, I'm glad we're up here at the end again, and I'd like for you to touch on it, but we're having a real problem. We love everybody to come, but you got to come during business hours. You have to have an appointment, or we have to know your own property.
Yeah.
And, well, we have people coming in, going through the houses, and we don't know about it.
Really?
Oh, yeah. On the weekends.
Well, I shut this gate now on the weekends. We're hoping that'll calm it
down. Well, what happened is that they were going through some of these.
Yep.
And they're just come in and parked and start walking around. So we've got to.
And you know, I want to put a gate up here, but then we got so many people living here,
going
and they
got to
go in and open up the gate. We don't have
a guard
gate yet.
Yeah.
And that's what we want, is a guard gate where somebody will man the gate.
Yeah.
And say, where are you going? Who's doing what?
Who are you visiting? And all that kind of stuff. Just so you can, you know all that. That's, I think it's Cardi's.
Oh yeah. But there you go. There you have it.
Yeah, it's beautiful. I'm in a lot of progress.
So we've seen the stucco today. I'm loving how it's going, the progression of it. If you're in a home that you're waiting for, I just want you to be reassured that we have every ounce of energy we have trying to get these things done. Because you understand, it's financially more feasible for us for these homes to be completed sooner than later.
Oh gosh, yeah.
All right.
We want them out.
So we are doing all we can to get these things done for you. But it is looking really well. We're actually having the Kentucky Amish
build our ESPs also. Mm-hmm. So they've kicked in. I've personally taken three traders up there.
You got three 10x20s.
I'm going up in the morning again. I'll leave here about 4.
And you can take some pictures tomorrow, and so we can post those
okay.
for everybody.
Yeah, I'll do that. I'm taking, like I said, all materials to try to finish the three. They've got a finishing crew and a framing crew of the mm-hmm. ESPs. Plus, they've also got 4 stick-built homes going up there right now under construction.
John's picking one up and bringing it back.
Yep, bringing one back Thursday. So mm-hmm. That's starting to rev up. I've been talking to some vendors to get all our supplies bought locally so we don't have to ship them anymore. Mm-hmm. Right now, we're kind of nursing that along until we can make our connections. I'm really excited about that whole process. And when you have a workforce like that, I mean, we could step up to where we're really revving this up where it's a lot smoother, more efficient, you know?
Yeah.
So we're excited.
And this is possibly the future spot for a lodge.
Yeah. Yep.
Okay. I mean, it's a beautiful evening, a beautiful show everything.
Yep.
Progress. And the beach. So when people can start going on their lots and stuff, we'll let them know.
Yeah. So in the morning, our process is in the morning that we'll be putting the conduit. There's a pipe that goes over top of the wire. Mm-hmm. And because of the whole situation we're in, we had to have special grounding and lug nuts and all this stuff, and we got that in, and then the inspectors gave us 2 or 3 different ways of doing this thing, and it's just been, I've never heard of it before, and every electrician I talked to, they've never heard of it, but we're doing what the state says. To alleviate all that, we've got a total different process in the prairie mm-hmm. that has already been bought, paid for, and inspected by the state to make sure that it is verified that it will work and be done. So that's going to be expedited a whole lot quicker
Great.
Than what we've done over here.
Okay.
But we do have everything we need in the beach to complete everything to get the wire in, you know?
Okay.
So we're good to go on Great. That. It's just a matter of time. The process is put the conduit on, put your 90s, make your junction with your wires in your meter center, mm-hmm. right? Then you got to put a lug nut wire, connect everything to it, ground it, and then you have to fasten the pipe to the post. Mm-hmm. Once that's all done, which should take probably 30 to 45 minutes for each pole, I would say, maybe an hour. We've got 34 poles to do. Mm-hmm. We got limited amount of labor. We've got 2, maybe 3 guys, maybe. That's how we know we got Brian for sure. Mm-hmm. And if we pull people off of builds to come out here, then we have homes not being done.
Right.
The people need their homes. No. So we're in a real dilemma, and it's hard to find skilled workers that will work. So once this is done, we're done. And that's probably the most frustrating part, is trying to get it done on time, you know? So we get that rolling. Once that's done, you guys will be notified. You can activate your meters, you know, and turn them on. You got electricity. Mm-hmm. The water in the sewer is already activated.
Okay.
Yeah. So that's it, everybody. So if you want to go back to the beginning of the video, we did show our stucco process, what it's looking like. We're mm-hmm. excited about that. And man, let the picture speak for itself, huh?
That's just beautiful.
This is crazy, Amanda.
You want to drive back down through the beach and let's go back to the office that way? Just kind of go down the road?
I think I got it blocked off with them trailers.
Oh, do they? Okay.
I can try. Let's see what we got. We're trying to keep people from pulling through the beach, and we're getting a lot of foot traffic now. People are, I guess, hearing about us, and they're coming through, and we're just, you know, because we don't have everything up and running and signs and fences and shrubs and...
We're just trying to keep everybody safe.
Yeah. Yep. Here we go. They moved one of them. So here's Malibu Way.
18 on each side, right?
Who names a street Malibu in Tennessee, Amanda?
Randy Jones.
Nobody has ever
Randy
done
Jones
that.
Randy Jones does. Probably the only one in the whole county.
Oh, listen, I had so many eyebrows raised at me when I wanted to do stuff around here. Everything that we've done here was out of the ordinary. Do you know that?
Always.
Everything here. Everything was unheard of. It was like, Randy, it's not going to work. Right? Mm-hmm. So the development wasn't going to work. Then the beach is not going to work. And then the road names. We're even getting slack from people we call Tombstone because it's death. Then building on this concrete is crazy.
Everything's crazy. Yeah.
Buying 160 acres, like you're stop.
Yeah.
Yep. But you know, man, I'm used to it. It's still hard.
Lord, I know it's hard, even though you're used to it.
Hey, even these foam panel houses.
Oh, they're staying late, Randy. They're still trying to get this together for you for Kentucky.
Everybody doubted our foam panel homes too.
Oh yeah, look at them.
You know. But we've sold almost 50 of them.
Yeah, I mean, come on.
And still selling more. Yep. Once we have this process down and we know what we're doing with stucco, we know about manufacturing these things, then I'm really going to say, okay, this is what we can do.
Exactly.
Look, she's hiding out. Yep. Hey, look at this right here. This is a container.
Wow.
That black container.
8x20.
It'll be mounted on a trailer tomorrow. Yep. Isn't that pretty?
Yeah. That is cool.
Can't get back through there.
It's going to be a rental, right?
That's going to be a rental. Yeah, I think up in Boone, North Carolina, really.
Yep.
So we have the trailer for that. That'll be sitting up on it.
We'll show it when it gets done. The red one here is for storage, right? Is this for storage?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Man, these guys are busting their tails.
I got to go help them, man. It's a long day.
It is.
Look at Jesse.
I know. And he worked till 3 in the morning, 11
Jesse,
to 3.
Go home.
What?
Go home.
What is that?
Yeah, what's home?
What is that?
You got to go to bed, man.
You're tired.
I'll finish up. Let's go on.
What's a bed look like?
Hey, them 2x6s? Yeah. Yeah, is that right? Yeah, they're yellow pine. That's all right.
That's all we got for right now.
Okay. Yep.
We'll have to send the cabinets and stuff on the next
Yeah, we're good.
Shot. Everything else, we've got that one cart over there.
Let's hide his face.
Yep. Wow. This is one here, and that's it?
Yep, that's it. Everything's on the truck. Everything that we could...
That's going to Kentucky, right?
And we got that list. We can keep track of all that, can't we? Just check it off and know what they got. Awesome.
Hey, let's run over and just show the outside of Robinson really quick.
Yeah.
I seen that, because that blue looks nice. And it's about to leave.
Yeah.
I think it leaves Monday.
Here's our container trailer.
Okay. That's it. Okay.
Yep.
There it is. That's the one that's leaving. I think it's leaving Monday.
Yeah, the trim.
That one's leaving Friday and Monday.
Yeah, the trim just came in for that.
Yeah.
Yep, and the caulk and everything. Yep.
That one they did the sheetrock?
Yep, sheetrock inside. That's Kelly's house. That's the one we had to redo the foam insulation in there.
There's Rob. Rob's still working.
Yeah.
Yeah. You give me the finger.
You're going to think. Look at that blue with the green roof. That looks really nice.
I've never seen all the color changes that we've done here. Mm-hmm. I mean, not us, but the customers have, done. I never thought it was a good combo,
I know, exactly.
But, yeah, all this, the ESP, the regular wood, the stain, the containers, the natural wood, the live edge. Mm-hmm. Good God. That's all I was thinking. Could you imagine a jam here and what everybody can see? You know, if we had, a lot of times our videos get about 3,000 or 4,000 people.
Mm-hmm.
If we could just get that many people come here to see what we do, it would be a success.
Yeah.
You know what? What's up, buddy?
I'm so slow. I should have said, I saw you coming.
Yeah. Yep. Everybody's moving. Everybody has a job here. So, everybody, hope you enjoyed this video. We'll be back not tomorrow. Amanda will be.
Well, I'm going to call you. We're going to do questions and Q&A right. tomorrow.
Good. Yeah.
So we're going to try and maybe do FaceTime, and then I'll get Lindsay's phone. We're going to work something out.
All right. And then I'll do some stuff up there to show you guys what's going on up with our with our Amish partnership and see how they're doing and come along.
Because if you send me some pictures before we do the show, we can go ahead and I can post those, make a little movie of it. And so just take a bunch of pictures and send me.
Well, I'll get there in the morning, and I'll go and take pictures of where they're building and everything and then get them
and
to
I'll
you
And I'll put it together
quick.
For you.
All right. Everybody, hope you had great great time watching this show. You're celebrating. You had time to see us.
We get very excited because of the progress. When you can see progress, that makes you feel good. Makes you feel accomplished because it's hard.
You know, and sometimes I see these videos or I think about what people think when they see this. And they're thinking, people that are buying homes from us, and they're like, if their house is not done yet or they've been waiting for a really long time.
Yeah.
And I'm sure they're thinking, oh, he's out fishing. Amanda's out, you know, getting her nails done, and we're just out.
Well, I usually am.
Or and worse than that, maybe we're incompetent of what we're doing. Mm-hmm. I've had a couple customers actually talk to me like I'm a little boy. And I was like, you know what? I exactly understand, because the way I run my own personal life in this company is not like a Fortune 500
it's not
company.
Traditional.
It is not. I run it with my heart, my soul. I run it the way I only know to do, you know. And some people, but the people that don't like that, they like the product and they like the price, but they don't like the process.
Yeah, exactly.
And I'm trying to be a better, not trying to do your process, but I'm trying to be better at my own process, which will never stop changing. I'll always continue to do better. So not admitting any kind of wrongdoing or laziness or inexperience, it's just something that'll always be evolving. And that's what I think is the beauty of this company, or any company. If you're not evolving, you're dying.
Yeah,
you're going
I
backward,
agree.
You know. Hey, everybody, have a great night. I'm gonna quit talking. We'll see you tomorrow. I'll be in Kentucky with our Amish partnership. Amanda will be here crying, wishing I was here to help her.
I really will.
All right, have a great night. We'll see you.